Hey guys, Chingum here, and before we begin this video, I wanted to go over a little bit of information that I forgot to go over while I was recording the tutorial. So let's get started. Something that you guys have to keep in mind when making spiral staircases is the fact that you have to measure the different heights that you're going to be aiming for. Sometimes if you have, it can be one block or two blocks off, and the spiral will not exit at the right place within the same step, so you would end up having to jump or edit your build a lot. So make sure that whenever you're making a build and you're going to add or incorporate a spiral staircase within it, that you make sure you compensate for that. Like the entrance and the exit, the distance between one and the other have to be symmetrical. It has to be an actual number, and it will require some planning to some extent. So make sure you guys keep that in mind, and without further ado, let's begin the tutorial, and I hope you guys enjoy it. Yo guys, this is Chris, aka Chingum here, and welcome back to yet another Minecraft tutorial. And today, we are going to be talking about a few things, including going over the tutorial of these two stairs that you are looking at on screen right now. Now, if I'm completely honest with you, I am more teaching you the strategy to get these spiral staircases to look the way they look, rather than teaching you how to make these, because it applies to multiple sizes, not just one. You guys can thank Simster, or JP English, whatever you guys are calling him nowadays, and Riley Skyler for requesting this tutorial, and yeah, let's get started. Alright guys, so the first thing you guys are going to need to make this staircase that you have right in front of me are the following materials. You are going to need some kind of wool to create the general shape of the build. You're going to need a block that is going to be used to fill in. You are going to be using a slab that is going to be used as the diagonal steps. You're going to be using the stairs, which are going to be on the straight bits. And then you're going to use the oak block for pretty much the shaping of the entire thing. Yeah, let's get started. So the first thing you're going to want to do is you're going to want to make a circle. And you're going to need a clearing for sure. So the first thing you're going to do is you're going to go three blocks like that. Then you're going to go two. Then you're going to go one. Then you're going to go two. Then you're going to go one, two, three. Then you're going to repeat the process. So 3, 2, 1, 2, 3. Repeat the process. 2, 1, 2, 3. And you pretty much repeat that once more. 1, 2, 1, 1, 2. And then you get this general shape that you are looking at right now. Now, the idea behind this is it's going to be implemented now. So the first thing you're going to do is you're going to connect the all four middles. So like right here, you're going to go across and connect it like so. And you're going to go over on this side. And you're going to connect it like so. And you're going to create that T shape across the whole thing. And then what you're going to do now is you're going to go to that one block, the one that's right in the middle of each corner, and you're going to connect it with that middle T like so. So you're going to go across in a straight line, and we're going to do it again. So you look at the corner right here, you're going to go across like this. Now the reason why I chose this type of circle to make this tutorial is because you want each step to be symmetrical. So if we went with the 5-2-1-2, I feel like the side steps, the ones that are going to be the straight ones, would be way too big. So make sure that whenever you're making the circle and you're designing the circle for this, that you make sure it has that that symmetry across all the steps, so it doesn't look funny when you're building it up. Now what you're going to want to do is you're going to go to the middle, and you're going to raise the pillar as long as you want it. This is pretty much like way too high for the tutorial, but that's pretty much what I'm going to do. And what you're going to take is you're going to take the block that I said you're going to fill stuff with, and you're going to fill in every single one of these gaps. And when you're done with that, you're going on to the next part of the tutorial. Alright, so once you finish filling everything up, you should end up with a shape kind of like this. It kind of looks like a flower if you kind of look at it. And what you're going to want to do here is you're going to take the block that you're using for the middle, which is pretty much the same block that I use for the framing. In this case, I'm going to switch it over to the all-sided lock because I feel like it's easier that way. And you're going to place it in the middle like so. And then what you're gonna do is you're gonna place the one that's on this, on the pillar facing this way, and the rest of them going across like so. And then what you're gonna do is you're gonna take the framing block, and you see all these divisions right here with the wool. You're going to pretty much follow that pattern, and if you follow that pattern all the way up and you get the pattern right, you should have the stairs perfectly symmetrical all the way to the top. So as you can see, we have that right there. That's up to that point. Then what you're going to want to do is you're going to take your framing block again, and you're going to go up one. Now, if you want to make it floating, of course, you would remove the bottom blocks. And eventually, I'm sure that you would end up removing the bottom pattern. I just left it so that you guys could visualize it better. And as you can see, what you're going to do here is you're going to fill this up to that point. You're going to put the block here as well. And what you're going to want to do is you're going to take the slab and you're going to go across just like that to get the general shape. And that's pretty much your first two flights right there of stairs. And then again, same thing. You would place one here, go across four, place the framing block, and now what you're going to do is you're going to go like so up to the next division, which is this one. And then you're going to fill this up like so. And then bam, you have your next flight. And then you're pretty much going to keep doing that. You're going to follow the pattern on the floor until you get the whole circle, or in general, like the height that you want. You might have to spin it once or twice. You might actually have to spin it just once, and you just want the stair to have a really cool and nice shape. And then, like you see here, connect it right there. Bam. And as you can see, it's starting to say shake. Now, I'm going to do like three or four more flights of stairs so you guys can actually visualize it better. So place a block there, place a block facing the pillar like so, then the rest go across like this, and then you're going to follow the pattern just like it is on the floor, like so, creating, it's kind of like a flower. Like when you look at it from above, it actually looks like a flower, so it's a pretty cool way to describe it. And then you're going to place the log here, and you're going to go over here and keep going. So boom, boom, and connect it right there. And now what you're going to do is you're going to fill these up like that. And then you're going to take your slab, of course, and go across. And as you can see, you're starting to get that really smooth shape. All right, guys. So last time I am going to do this, and I'm actually going to remove this so you guys can visualize it better. So you're going to take your stair against the middle pillar, place it like so, go one, two, three, four blocks out, and then place this right there. And then you're just going to trace the pattern like so, connecting this with the center pillar. And then you're going to take this and fill it up. I know I destroyed that, I gotta fix it right there. And that is the last part of the straight bit. And then once more for the diagonal bits, you're going to again follow, you're gonna place this here, you're gonna go there, there, and there, and there. And I believe you connect it right here, like so. Boop-a-boop. Then you're going to take your block and you're going to fill it up. And then you take your slab and you go across one, two, three. Bam. Then you have your flight of stairs. Now, something that you're definitely going to want to do, and if you don't want your stairs looking like you're going to fall over, is you're going to want to take the slab of the framing block, and you're pretty much going to want to, like, frame it just like this. So, for example, here, places like this, here, here. So in places where it would look flat, you would probably like put the slab to kind of give it that extra framing bit right there, and it just makes it look nicer, really. Of course, if you want to like have your door on the side, you would have to like extend this floor a little bit right here and then turn. If you like, the good part about this is that you can like pretty much cover up the connecting block right here, which I didn't do with that one, and it just makes it look a lot smoother. It makes it look a lot better, and you just have the framing like so. So of course, when you're going up and down, it feels just like this. So remember, make the flower, divide it in even parts, and then follow the pattern all the way up. That is the strategy. You can do this at pretty much any size. In this video, we're just covering the large stairs because I feel like that is the easier part. That is the shortest amount of time for this video. If I weren't to cover all of those, then it would take forever. So now that we're done with this one and you guys know the strategy, let's move on to the next one. Alright guys, so for the next one, what you're gonna need is you're gonna need some type of wool or some type of framing block to make the circles, and you're gonna need the slab that you're gonna use to make the actual steps, and then a block that you will use at the end to actually frame it. So let's get started. So the thing you're gonna do is you're gonna need two circles, right? So give yourself some space. Make sure that if you're using this, you have actually, I can't say a minimum amount of space, but I do know that's pretty big. So what you're gonna need is you're gonna need to make a circle. So 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 2, 1, 2, and then you connect it and wrap it up just like that. And then you're gonna go and you're gonna find the middle, and you're gonna do, I believe it's there. 1, 2, 3. Is it there? Yeah, I believe it's there. Yep, there you go. So 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3. And then 1. And then basically what you're gonna have is you're gonna have that circle within a circle, and what that's going to do is it's going to create like a platform for the rest of the slabs to kind of go into, and I'll explain what I mean by that in a second. So what we're gonna do now is we're gonna grab our world edit wand, and we're gonna select this area right here, and we are going to first of all get rid of all that grass so that when we stack it, it doesn't get in the way. So we're gonna do //replace 31 with 0. There we go, boom. Let's do that and that. So //replace 175 with 0, //replace 38 with 0. There we go. So now that you have that area selected, what you're gonna do is you're gonna stack it up as many blocks as you need to make your stairs. In this case, I'm just gonna stack it up 10. And that should be pretty much it. Now, I hope the shaders don't make it hard to visualize, but what you're gonna wanna do is you're gonna want to start at the center, just like with the other one, and you're gonna place your blocks like so, and then you're just pretty much going to go up, which is pretty self-explanatory, really. But there's one specific part that is extremely tricky, and if you don't get it right, it will definitely mess up the stair. So here's the tricky part. Once you get here, to this bit where you're at like standing straight at the edge of the circle, you're gonna have to connect here like a little flat bit before you can go up, and I'll explain that in just a second. You're gonna have like an L shape of some sort, and I'm actually trying to figure it out myself again. So I know for a fact that you have right there, and then here's the L shape right here. So here's where the actual shape will kind of go into again. Actually, kind of forgot how I did my own design. I think it was right there, and then you get the shape right here again. Yeah, there you go. So you're gonna have like a little flat bit right there, and then it's gonna go up. So we're gonna keep going. We're gonna go up again, and up again, and up again, and up once more. You've gotten to this area right here, so what you're gonna want to do is you're gonna want to flatten it up a bit, and then you're gonna get this L shape right here. It's kind of like an L shape type of thing, and basically what you're gonna do with that is that's the step to the next area. So it's like a diagonal block, two to two, that connects one wall with the other, which I believe I did it down here too. Yeah, there you go. So yeah, that's how it was. So you have like the little diagonal blocks that connect with the wall, and then you're just gonna keep going again. Slab, slab, slabby-doodle, slab, like that. Keep going, you're still going up like so. And then we've made it again to this part, so we connect it right here. We make it a little bit of a flat bit. It's kind of like a, what do you call it, like another flight, like a landing area, you know. I don't know how exactly, I know they have a name, and pretty much like you stop there to, like that's usually where you have doors and stuff like that, to other areas, but Anyways, I'm not here for the technical stuff. I'm just here to show you how to make the stair. And then again, you're gonna make it flat like so, and then here's where it would go up. Oops, I broke it. I break everything I touch. There you go. And then you're gonna have this like L shape right here. It kind of goes up to the next level and flattens this bit up like so. So you would have this flat up right here. Now, the reason why the other one over there looks different was because the circles were a different size. But again, the strategy will continue being the same despite the circle size. Just make sure that as long as you have the two circles and it's like an even space from every area, the stair would look fine. Also, another reason why that one looks different is because I took World Edit and I pretty much replaced the wool with air. /replace 35.0. There you go. And that's pretty much why it looks that way. Also, I didn't do the full circle like I did on this one here. It actually overlaps, so you actually have the bit. And then what you would do is you would take your framing block and you would go along like so. You would just place it against the blocks, and just like in the other one, whenever you have a flat bit, you would grab the sandstone version of that block, and you would pretty much kind of just make sure that you have that little over bit that makes it look well supported and it looks like you're actually not gonna fall off. It just gives you the borderline. That's like the actual way to describe it. So again, I'm gonna grab the slab for this, and what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna go over the bits where it's flat like so. So here, 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 here. Then I'm just gonna keep on going like that in every flat bit, just to make sure that it doesn't look flat, because I don't want it to look flat. You know, you don't want it to look flat. That's definitely not what you want. The only bit is that there, like, it looks kind of flattish, but you can't really do much about that one. And yeah, that's pretty much it for this type of stair. However, if you wanted to do something different, and these are pictures that Riley Schuyler has sent me himself, you would keep the wool and you would only remove the outer levels. So I'm going to demonstrate what I mean by that. So you would literally just remove the wool from this area like that, and then remove the wool from this area like that, and then you remove the wool from this area like so, and then finally remove the wool from the other area like so, right? And then you have the middle piece right there, and what that does, it kind of makes it like it's kind of like going around a tower or a pillar of some sort, and that's basically like your support for the stair. It looks like it's being held by that, and then you can kind of go again along the outside with whatever block you're using to frame it, and that just creates the feeling that it's like well supported and stuff. Actually, if you have a tower within a tower, this actually does a really well job, because it's basically what we had with a two wall. Like, you have a big tower, you just make a smaller circle in the middle, and then you have this stair, and you can have like a spiral staircase within the tower, which is something that in the past I attempted a few times and I was never able to make it, but coming up with this design kind of changes that for the future of my projects. Oh, I apologize guys, I have hiccups. But that's pretty much it for this tutorial. Thank you very much for watching. Please remember to rate, comment, and subscribe. Share this video if you enjoyed, and stay tuned for more Minecraft tutorials, because in the near future we are going to have those medium and those small stairs. There's one more coming up in design that is going to be for a 2x2 space, so stay tuned for that. Really, really awesome stuff coming. Some of those designs were submitted by other people too, so that's pretty awesome. We also have a new crane design. So we had the one that Carl Felt designed, and I kind of designed one of my own. If you guys actually want to see all the tutorials coming, some of these we've already done, some of these are coming soon, like this one's coming soon. This one is the one we're working on right now, but there's a part two coming. There's another one over here, I just haven't like started it yet. It's like around here or something. There's another one that's going to be around here, so I kind of like set it up in a special way, and I kind of already started on all of those. There you can see the fishing hut 1, 2. So anyways, thank you very much for watching. Like I said before, I really hope you guys enjoy these stairs and put them to good use. If you guys do something with these, please I beg you guys, send me an Imgur link, or Imgur, I don't know how you guys pronounce it, but send it to me in the comment section below of this tutorial, because like, it would be really cool to see like what you guys do and stuff. Like, just, I just think that would be like really awesome. So make sure you send me a link, or like on Discord or something, send me a screenshot of what you guys did. I want to see what you guys do with these designs, and I can't wait to see what people have in store. It really is exciting, because I know that a lot of people struggle with these, and I just think it's really, really awesome. So again, thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you guys later.
Goodbye.